Welcome to the runway. As you know, in fashion, one day you're in, and the next day, you're out. For this challenge, the tables were turned. Usually, your models work for you, but this week, you had to work for them. You had to create a look that would make them stand out and be noticed at an industry event. You had $100 and one day to put it together. All right, let's meet the judges. First, we have American designer Mark Bauer. Filling in for Nina Garcia, we have editor for Marie Claire magazine, Zoe Glasner. And award-winning costume designer and top celebrity stylist, whose clientele includes Angelina Jolie, Jen Raid. We will score your designs as they come down the runway. One of you will be named the winner, and one of you will be out. Let's start the show.
Celine looks absolutely amazing. Oh my God, I actually have a chance of winning this. She is the only one that looks extremely chic, and I tailored it to the T.
My client's idea with my idea was perfect. She's romantic and then rough. I'm like elegant and then jagged edges. I feel like no one else is doing what I'm doing here.
I am so happy because Tanisha looks so good in it. I feel like my client's happy and I feel like it definitely represents me as a designer.
I remember doing the first look and being like, oh no. I was a little too literal with the beachwear, making sure it could transform, it could get water on it, and could roll around the sand, and I don't think that's necessarily what they were looking for.
Each team must create a second look.
I got excited. I think everyone else was like, oh no, we've got to do this huge look in a day, but I remember thinking, oh, I think that just saved me. I would have loved to spend more time on it.
We had to leave the pins in the zippers because we didn't have time to sew them on. Actually, on the runway, it kind of looked stunning because the pins gave like this sort of like metal sheen, and you couldn't really tell they were pins.
I don't know what kind of woman you're used to, but I'm not
let
you speak to
let's
me
let's not
kind
talk
of way.
About what type of woman I'm listening
right,
talking
I'm done.
To.
Everson and Crystal, they were paired together and they were kind of a mess. I wouldn't say it directly affected me. I don't think I was like thrown off by it. But you're working, you're frustrated, you're trying to get things done. And when someone's just bitching, you're like, shut up.
Close.
Hello.
Jordana.
Hi.
Well, we decided to do a bathing suit out of macrame.
You sure have.
This is a little wrap pant, sort of like change it up a little bit.
A wrap pant?
A wrap
yeah,
pant.
Yeah, she will take it off and we'll have a bathing suit on the bottom.
I will tell you, I am completely intrigued by the top. Okay. I love the concept of this pant. The fact that there's a bathing suit underneath it, to me, doesn't matter.
Okay, then.
So then why don't we just strike it?
If I'm wrong, you can shoot me. But I don't think so. I just think it's a distraction.
All right, so.
Tell me about this.
So I'm still working on this. It's all hand-dipped. Like, all of this is hand-dipped. The actual bottom of the lace is going to go right into the shoe, so the shoe's going to be covered.
Okay. What's that?
So I'm trying to figure out a beautiful way to do a panty, and I know we've already discussed that. Yeah. This is actually, we permapleated in a microwave today.
Very clever.
We wet it, we twisted it, and then threw it in the microwave for a minute, and it came out in this gorgeous shape.
It's beautiful. And you know, from a distance, the lace doesn't even read as lace. It just reads as this wonderful water.
It's almost like a sea foam.
We've been having such a good time working together.
Are you concerned about time?
No, now that we are striking the bikini, yeah. We are really...
Strike the bikini.
Yeah, we are really not concerned.
And resolve that.
Yeah, resolve this.
Thank you.
Thank you both.
Thank you, Tim.
The challenge with the model was our client. Matar was my model. And, you know, I'm sketching ideas. She said, oh, I want it sexy. I want it flowing. I want it. She's so funny. She has a little accent.
Sexy, but not too much.
Right.
I want something that will show my body, but not to expose too much. I don't want something too big.
Right.
And if it's long, then I just want it tight.
Right.
Something tight.
Sexy, flowing, chiffon, blah, 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 romantic, all of these different adjectives. And then she breaks it down. Then she says, and rock. I'm like, rock? You know, how does rock, punk rock fit into that? I'm like, oh boy. The outfit turned out great. We were in the top three. Go figure.
Hey, Tim.
I'm here to check in, and I'm going to start right here. How are you all doing?
We're doing well.
We're starting our avant-garde piece.
Yeah, talk to me.
Irina had this really beautiful idea for a macrame bag.
It is beautiful.
Yeah. She mentioned that she loves wearing neutrals with sort of fluorescent.
Yeah, the only thing is, you're talking about this girl that the judges haven't even met about how she likes neutrals,
right.
She likes the crafty aspect. The judges are merely going to say, well, we only care about how this looks.
Right.
Because we thought, you know, fashion pants are great, but let's do a skirt. Let's do something more fun and frilly.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then the idea was to take, we found this really great stretch wool knit, and it's like a pullover.
I just don't understand how this piece works.
It goes, it's sheer, and it goes over the top,
and
it's off the shoulder.
I know it's not permanently affixed, but on the runway,
the model's wearing this,
she's not taking it off.
Yeah, but it's so sheer that like when the lights
it's
are going to hit it, it's going to be completely sheer, and it comes down like this.
No, I get it, and it's a cute look.
Thank you.
So how did this evolve?
Because it's avant-garde, we want to go as out of control as possible. So it's going to be an oversized macrame design that kind of extends across the bust line.
Wow. I will tell you, I love the idea.
High five.
I love that you said that.
All right.
We're going to get that.
Okay, back to work. Back to work. To work. Thank you, guys.
Hi, I'm Philip Carrion for Garnier, and today I'm going to show you a look that's all about beautiful side-swept waves. Prep your hair with Garnier Fructis Wonder Waves Shampoo and Conditioner. Next, you want to use Wonder Waves Wave Defining Mousse, and I want you to use about this much, and scrunch it through all the way around. Once you got your hair all blow-dried, create a low side part. Take a section and spray it with Wonder Waves Wave Enhancing Spray. Put your curling iron in and roll it under, moving it in towards your head. I start at one end and work my way to the back of your ear on this side.
Hi, I'm Collier Strong, consulting makeup artist for L'Oreal Paris. Today I'm going to show you how to get a classic beauty look that'll go with any outfit. First, I'm going to start with Bare Naturel Mineral Foundation, apply in circular motions to the skin. Next, I'm using Bare Naturel Mineral Concealer just underneath the eye and a little across the lid. Now, to start the eye, I'm using Hip Kohl Eyeliner. You can also wet this applicator to intensify the application. Next, I'm using coordinating shades of Wear Infinite, starting with the lightest shadow. This adds brightness. Next, I'm using the medium tone color to give us a light wash of color over the entire lid. Now I'm running the darkest shade of shadow underneath the lower lashes. It's very important to connect the top part of the eye shadow to the lower part of the eye shadow.